You know, I think we're trying to build a hypothesis, right? The important part is that nobody's ever lived through any of this. We haven't been through it. I know that's sort of Captain Obvious, but it's important to understand that as we're sifting through some of the ashes that are in the stock market, the question becomes, what's next? We think investors are starting to give 2020 a mulligan, thank goodness, and starting to focus on what's going to happen in 2021. And so, you know, we have to develop a working hypothesis. The first is really that, you know, this virus will peak in about 2 to 3 months. Time is really, really critical here, right? The problem is with the stimulus that's coming on, we expect the Fed and Congress with fiscal stimulus to basically open the gates as much as they possibly can. The problem is that only buys you so much time. And if this virus turns out to be more difficult, we have to stop full economic activity longer than expected. Mm-hmm. I think you could see some real some significant economic damage that maybe isn't priced in quite yet.
That's the problem, is we don't know which way we're going. I thought it was interesting you said exactly. People are already going from FOMO, fear of missing out, to FOMO, which is the fear, no. Fear of not getting
out.
FOMO's back already,
right.
You think. I mean, we're up just a couple percentage points in a week, and you think people are already chasing this market. And we've seen that with the fund flows. I mean, there are big inflows into equities. Are these people going to be hurt by this reaction?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say, right? I think the fact that we're getting some, as Dr. Fauci called it, you know, some small little positive benefit or small little positive outlooks on the virus and the spread and the change, the fact that social distancing is actually having an impact, I think the market's starting to pick up on that, frankly. And you know, one of the things that's really important, and I really like James Bullard here from the Fed on this, he talked about this being an investment in our public health. This is not a crash of the market like it was in 08 when housing and debt were so debilitating to the economy. So the sooner we can get this going, of course, I think the sooner things will snap back.
Yeah.
The longer it goes, we're going to get more bankruptcies in small business. We're going to get more difficulty to get the engine started again. And when you're putting money in the market today, which we are, by the way, we're becoming more optimistic.
Yeah.
But you're betting that this doesn't take too long. That's really your game that you're thinking about.
All right, Mr. Vogelsang, thank you. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Kelly.